So these flow chart scheme people were using in earlier stage. Nowadays, each and everything has been configured inside the simulator. So we will not recommend anybody to have the literature of all these to refer those literature before starting the simulation. So all these things has been configured inside the simulator. You just have to explore where these options are available in the HiSys. So in HiSys, you will find an option like method assistant. Once you click the method assistant, then it will ask few questions to you. It will ask whether you are going to specify the component type or you are going to specify the process type. You know for what purpose you are going to perform the simulation activity, whether you are in a position to provide the component type or you are in a position to provide the process type. Based on the information available with you, you select either option. If you have provided the option like component type, then it will ask whether it is the chemical system or hydrocarbon system or anything else like a special like a sour system or electrolyte or aromatics, etc. Based on this, you will select, then it will recommend what are the methods applicable for your system that you can use for simulation. Second option was process type, whether your process involve chemical, electrolyte, environmental, oil and gas processing, and metallurgical, petrochemical, power and refining. These are the methods, means these are the process type that you can select, and further it will recommend these are the methods which are applicable for your process, that anyone method you that it will it has recommended you can use any one method for your process and proceed for the simulation activity. So let's see how we can perform this in
hello sir.
Yes sir.
Sir, are these features available in Pro 2 also?
I think yes, but again I will check and confirm. I think
okay sir.
All the simulators are having almost 80 to 90% similarity. So whatever options you are having in HiSys,
it okay.
may have in other simulators also.
Yeah, Aspen is much easier than Pro 2.
Yes, it is much easier.
Okay, sir. Okay.
So once you have selected, see, for example, I have selected the component like methane. Are you able to see the screen? Methane, is it ethane propane?
Yes, sir. We can see.
बेटा जाओ मम्मा पास जाओ मम्मा पास जाओ मम्मा पास जाओ आप
हेलो
यस सर वी कैन सी
ओके सॉरी बेटा आप जाओ once we have selected the components involved in our system like methane, ethane, propane, butane and all those things, now we don't know which method I should select. I don't know. So for that, what I will do, I will go to the method assistant. I just click the method assistant. Then it will ask whether I can provide the specific component type or specify the process type. I will select first specify the component type. I have selected this method component type. Then as we know, methane, ethane, propane, butane, pentane, these all are the hydrocarbons. I will select the hydrocarbon system. Again, it is asking, does the mixer contains petroleum assay or hypo component? Because I have selected the hydrocarbon, then in the hydrocarbon we have two options: whether we have the pure component or we have the assay or hypo components. So based on the component available with us, we don't have any hypo component. So I will select no. Now it has listed down all the methods that are applicable for our system: Hughes, Peng, Robinson, Lee, Kessler, Plocker, or SRK. So it has recommended us these are the methods that you can use for your system for simulation. Okay. This way we can decide. Now, second option is specify the process type. You have specified the process type, then select whether it is petrochemical, oil and gas, or whatever. Let's say it is petrochemical. Then it is asking for aromatics, BTS extraction, ethyl production, ethyl benzene production, or ethyl plant property package. See, I will not proceed with this because it is asking whether it is aromatics or extraction. See, for whenever we are using any extraction method, then there are some special kind of solvent are being used. So mostly for any extraction process and all extraction kind of simulation, we have some special kind of package. With the help of that, we proceed for the simulation, especially for the extraction, like those who have the experience of the BTX, we can extract the BTX benzene, toluene, and xylene from the pygas by using the sulfolane solvent. If I say that we are having the pygas composition, and I want to extract benzene, toluene, and xylene by using the sulfolane solvent, so any method means HYSIS will not. HYSIS does not support the sulfolane component for so many cases. If you do the 100 trials, then maybe one or two methods you will be able to do the means convert the simulation. Otherwise, you will not be able to convert the simulation. So right now we will leave this portion. So oil and gas processing. In general, cubic equation of like Peng, Robinson, CPA or SRK. So these are the methods that we can use for selecting the thermodynamic package. So now we are in the position to select the thermodynamic package. It has recommended whether we can use the Lee Kessler blocker or Peng Robinson or SRK, any method we can use. Again, selection of the thermodynamic package is very wide subject. Broadly speaking, we have discussed only about based on this flow chart scheme. One second. Yes. Broadly speaking, we have discussed only about based on this flow chart scheme and taken the help of the HYSIS assistant. Based on that, we had decided which property package or which thermodynamic package is suitable for our system. Otherwise, if somebody wants to go in detail of this, then it's very, very long topic. It is have you minimum you will be having 100 pages or more than 100 pages based on the selection of the thermodynamic package. So it's very vast topic. If somebody wants to go in detail, then he or she can go in detail, and I can share the literature for that also. So as of now we will discuss the next topic. I think based on this, those who don't have any background about the simulation, based on this information, he or she can proceed with simulation. If anybody wants to go in detail, then either you take the help of the Aspen HYSIS or have study some literature, especially thermodynamics. So next we will discuss about material and energy stream and explanation of the append properties. So once you have selected all the components, and based on the components you have selected the thermodynamic package, suitable for your system. Now you jump into the simulation environment. Now once you have jumped into the simulation environment, now you people are familiar with this interface. So if you have taken the material stream, if you have taken this material stream, it will ask for some information like temperature, pressure, flow rate and composition. Let's say we have provided this temperature as 50 degrees centigrade and pressure 1 kg and flow rate 1000 and the composition. Now I have defined the streams. Once your stream has been defined, now you are in a position. Now you are in a position to check the properties which this thermodynamic package has been selected for your case. All the properties you can select from here. You can check all the properties which are applicable for this case that you can identify from this location. Now, up till now, everybody is familiar. Now I'm going to tell you what are the append properties. Append properties is basically the properties which are listed over here, like from molecular weight to viscosity index. These are the only not properties which is applicable for the system. There are some other properties also that are related to the thermodynamics, and sometimes you are supposed to calculate those also. So even though simulator has calculated all those properties, but those properties has not been listed over here. So those additional properties that are not listed over here, those we call as the append properties. That append properties is you can add by clicking over the plus sign available at the bottom, that is property correlation control. You have this option, new correlation set list, then append new correlation. Then this is basically the append to move the properties up and down. These are the options. So we will go to the append new correlations now. Once you want to the append new correlation, then you can see these are the methods, these are the systems available inside the HYSIS, like black oil, electrolyte, gas, petroleum, RFG, RVP, solid standard, GC, oil gas feed. So whatever properties you want to add in your system, that you can add. Let's say in our case, what we are having, let's say we are taking the petroleum. Now you can add as many properties available here in your simulation. So let's say I want to add the octane number. Now let's say we are going to add the flash point. Now we have added this flash point. See, you have added the flash point over here. It is not calculating the flash point for this system because it's very light component. Now add any other property like octane number, whether it is octane number, so these are the properties which you can add in your system. It will populate only those properties which are applicable for this case. Let's say any property which is applicable for this case, it will populate the value of those properties inside the list. See. I have entered viscosity index, then flash point, then Ron, research octet number, hydrogen content, freezing point, D86. All the information, it was not calculated for this particular stream, but it was calculating the kinetic viscosity for this stream. For that, its value is 0.1924. Kinematic viscosity -43.37. So in different units, it is calculating the properties. So in short, the objective of this was how to add the properties inside your material stream. By default, the only properties mentioned was like liquid volumetric flow. Later on, we have added viscosity index. Then all these properties we have added. Out of these properties, it was calculating only the kinematic viscosity. So the value of those properties has been populated over here. Else is it is showing the empty. Now, it is not calculating the D86 of 5% of petrol. So for calculating the D86, there are other methods also that we had discussed, I think, in attachment. Let's go to the analysis, then go to the create, then create, then it will pop this window, then boiling point curve, add. Your boiling point curve has been added over here. Now check here, performance, everything, D86, D86, TBP D86, and ASTM D86 110. See, now you can ask that whether even I have provided the pure component composition, your component composition of my case, how we are able to see the D86 data of this, how we are able to see the D86 or TBP data for this. The reason is whenever we are in most of the cases in refinery, we are doing the analysis of the streams based on the GC component or the distillation data like D86 or TBP. So if we have only that GC method, GC data available with us, and we want to proceed the GC data to simulation, then if you see that GC data is having that so many components, like let's say the sample is having the carbon atom C1 to C10, so it will contains all the components from C1 to C10, and even all the isomers which are applicable, like pentane has 3 isomers, then butane, pentane, hexane, all the isomers, like it will list on in GC. So it is very, very difficult how to identify if any component is missing. It is very difficult to identify which component is missing and how to provide the composition inside the simulation. So normally, in a refinery, we do the distillation analysis. In case we want to proceed and we want to match the data, so what we are doing is once we are having the GC data and again we are having the distillation data, we can link these data, like a pseudo component with the component. For example, if you have defined the pseudo component in your system and it is calculating the normal boiling point as 150, then you will identify that which component is having the boiling point of 150. So in the place where your pseudo component has written NBP 150, So you can replace that position with the pure component which is having the boiling point of 150. So this way you can do the changeover from your pseudo component to the pure component. I think at this stage you may not be able to understand everything about this. So just forget about that. Just imagine you are proceeding for the simulation with the pure component or the pseudo component. That's it. Don't mix these two.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
So is there any in the HiSys, is there any possibility to check how their TVP convert TVP data convert into the D86?
For TPP, there are correlations. Then based on that correlation, we are converting the TPP data into D86. I think TD86 equal to TPP raised to the power B something. These kind of correlations are there, and this A and B, these correlations values are different for different cases. So
can we check that correlation?
HiSys is having everything inside the which correlation it is using to convert your D86 to TPP data, and which correlation it, whatever methods, whatever procedures it is using, everything has been inside the HiSys. You have to just explore. Everything has been documented. D86 to TBP data that I told you that D86 equal to A T TBP raised to the power B, where A and B are the correlation parameters. D86 temperature. So these correlations we have to provide. And even though there are various tools available on the internet, the various Excel sheets available on the internet, based on that you can convert your D86 also. But most likely we are not doing this conversion. HiSys, once we have provided the D86 data inside D86 or D1160, any data we have provided inside the HiSys, it already convert all those data to the TBP data for the calculation. We don't need to convert all those data into the TBP data. It will convert itself. And now if you want to see which method it is using to convert these D86 to TBP, that we can search inside that HiSys manual, that which correlation basically it is using, that you can find inside the HiSys itself.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
So we were discussing about the append properties inside. Even though we have defined your streams like pure component or pseudo component, or based on the assay, you have defined your stream based on the pseudo component. So even for that also, you can check all the properties, and whatever properties is not listed in default, you can add those by using the append properties. And if you want to save it for future, then save it and proceed. Otherwise, for normal days activity, normal means not very advanced stage simulation, in normal days, whatever simulation activity, whatever properties we are calculating, all those things has been listed over here. The discussion for append properties was just to you people are familiar about what are the append properties. That's it. Otherwise, not in normal days you won't be using this append properties method. Yes, just for your own interest you can explore all these things. Now once you have decided your what are the components inside your system, what are the thermodynamic package that is applicable for your system, and you have selected the thermodynamic package for your case, then you have entered inside the simulation environment. The very first thing those who are working in EPC company, they are most likely calculate used to this simulation tool or any tool to calculate the bubble point and dew point of that stream. Most likely they are calculating these all these